Okay, welcome to this week's check-in with presented by O'Neill with Trilly Designs Red Bull Gas Rider, Justin Barcia. Dude, you've been on fire lately. Has something changed in recent weeks? I mean, the results, the speed has been picking up.
Everything's just been clicking. Since Daytona, I would say we just got my setting really comfortable. I was ready. I've been ready to do this for a while now. You know, I had speed in the beginning of the season, but just didn't get everything to click together. So yeah, now everything's clicking and I'm super comfortable on the bike and having fun. So it's been a lot of fun racing. I've been enjoying it. A lot of good passes and battles. God, battles out to Wazoo, man. It's been fun. There's no rest out there. It's great.
At this point in the season, are you still doing radical testing, or is it just like slight refinements?
Just honestly, a click here and there on the on the suspension during the weekend. Like I said, this the new frame this year is very adaptable, I would say. We found a setting 4 weeks ago with the fork, and that was it. We were all good, and yeah, the bike's good. And this week we doing some outdoor testing, and so far so good. We rode Monday, and I was super happy on the bike. Tested a whole bunch of stuff, and felt really comfortable. So yeah, we'll go test some more this week, and just enjoying riding. Honestly, it's been enjoyable and fun, and yeah, I love it.
What's it like going from Supercross to outdoors? Like, is it going really fast?
No, or, you know? I always used to think that back in, or feel that back in the day, but going to Paula, it was quite fun. I enjoyed it. Track was good. Oh, and track wasn't crazy rough, so it was like just a fun day of riding. And yeah, no, not that crazy really. We'll see tomorrow. Maybe it'll be rougher and find some stuff, but no, not too crazy.
I saw you out at Nuevo in the rain.
I love it. Huh? I'm hoping it rains towards the end of the week and I go ride there again. Yeah. I growing up in Jersey a little bit and riding, just there's tons of sand tracks there. Just go anywhere and ride sand. So Nuevo kind of brings back like childhood memories a little, just going riding sand pits.
Dude, that place is brutal. There's like not one place to rest.
No rest there. And there was like 7 million puddles. And it was like a little kid wheeling through puddles and tearing up a brand new outdoor bike. Cody had to give her a polish and make it look good after that. But I like that stuff. I think it's fun. And that's the kind of riding I like. So I hope when I do retire in the next couple of years, hopefully I can keep doing something with moto and can just go ride a little bit of everything. Little trails, little whatever, keep it fun.
Yeah. So, like you said, a couple adjustments.
Yep.
And getting more comfortable and everything.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts about the last, whether there's 7 races left?
Man. Yeah, it's all about comfort as a rider. You when you find that comfort, you know, and for 4 weeks now, we've had clicker changes. So to me, that says the rest of the season's going to be awesome because we can adapt to the bike really easily. Going to try a few things to get a little bit better starts because at this top level, it's just a little thing that can make the biggest difference. And and that could be me moving a little on the bike or trying something like that or a little adjustment on the bike to make it better. But all in all, I'm looking for a lot more podiums, definitely some wins, and let's keep it strong and the biggest thing, keep it fun. And the way it's going right now, I don't see that being an issue.
Okay, I was just telling you that we finally got our factory edition press bike. Super stoked. It was like sitting there in our office, I just sit there and stare at it.
Such a good looking bike.
It looks so good.
I think
something about the gas rate is cooler than a Honda.
Yeah, and obviously Troy Maki, they did some good designs on this thing, made it look good. And when I heard they were doing a factory edition bike, I was so stoked. And to see it, I was like proud to have my name on it. So yeah, they crushed it, and it's a good motorcycle.
What is your favorite part on this bike? Show it to
favorite
me.
Favorite part on this bike. What's my favorite part? I mean, we got the tip. You got the tip. I like
the tip.
the factory tip there. What else? The hubs, I'll agree to say sick. I like the color hubs. But, I mean, then for me, it's the exhaust, though. That's probably the fanciest part, the exhaust. Acro absolutely crushes it. Like, that's just look at those welds. That's just work art. I don't see that anymore. Well done, Acro.
Was there Acro pipe on the two-stroke you raced at Straight Rhythm?
Exhaust.
Yeah, I didn't realize that they made two-stroke stuff.
Yeah, I think they do a little special stuff for this brand, KTM Gas Gas Husky. They crush it. They treat us really well, so we're stoked to have them.
Okay, on a non-moto tip, I've seen your Cannondale mountain bike hanging on the ceiling at Roy Cyclery. So you're a Cannondale athlete now.
Yeah.
That's for a couple of years now, right? Or is this the first year?
No, a couple of years now. Mm-hmm. They treat me well, but my big thing is Zip. I've been with Zip for probably 5+ years now.
Mm-hmm. That's wheels, correct?
Yeah, Zip wheels, SRAM. They have a ton of brands. So SRAM's the mothership, and then they have a ton of really cool brands below them. They have Cork power meters and things like that. So those guys, they're obviously in Indy. They're super into, you know, Indianapolis 500 and all that stuff, and they make epic carbon fiber parts. Maybe one day we can get them to make some dirt bike parts, actually. Yeah. That'd be cool.
So, speaking of SRAM, are you going to have that new drivetrain?
Oh, gosh. I watched the video, and it looks absolutely epic, and I'm drooling for one. I'll let them sell a whole bunch first, and then I'll get mine. But, yeah, they're crushing it right now in the market, for sure. Wheels, drivetrain, epic. Rock shocks, they have rock shocks. Mm-hmm. Yeah. They own it, all the cool stuff.
Yeah.
So I'm always stoked when I'm with rad brands, and I love cycling and anything to do with that. So it's...
Was the cycling obsession something that resulted from when you were training with Johnny, or were you always kind of into it?
I was always into it. I got into it when I kind of first got on JGR, and I brought Scott with me to that team, and obviously my big thing was bicycles with them, and then me and Ben and all the guys on the team rode together, had fun.
You had like the Thursday night races.
Oh, gosh, yeah. North Carolina was epic for doing fun bicycle rides. Got to it then trained with Tom D for a long time, and that even excited my bicycle thing even more. Mm-hmm. And now I just have so many friends that cycle and race, and friends with a ton of athletes and brands. I actually just brought a new sponsor on the feed, which they do like it's kind of like Amazon for athletes. They just sell everything like Normatex supplements, hydration, all that kind of stuff. So I'm with them, and then I SRAM, Zip, Juro helmets. Like there's so many. I have a lot of personal little sponsors to the cycling industry, and that's just it's just my passion. I love it, and I plan on living in England quite a bit when I retire, and I know I love cyclocross. That's kind of like, I don't do it that much, but I love gravel bikes and cyclocross, so I want to get into some bicycle racing. Nothing too serious, but anything I do, I take quite serious, so we'll see where that leads me. But yeah, I love bicycles.
I can imagine you got the skill to do the cyclocross bikes, upstairs.
It's really the closest thing to dirt bikes. It's a short, really intense race, hopping upstairs, hopping over stuff. I think that would suit me quite well. So see where that world brings me.
All right, last question. I'm gonna watch your face light up. How's dad life?
Dad life is awesome. It's been hard the last 2 days, going from the race and then literally motocross on long days testing, and then I'm here all day today, so haven't got to see him a ton. Just he's pretty much sleeping when I get home, but he's awesome. Yeah, we're absolutely loving it. He's got probably more frequent flyer miles than any normal human already. We went from Florida to California, and he's been to pretty much every race besides Oakland. So it's been, the fun factor right now in racing has been so cool, and having my kid there makes it even better.
Nice. Thanks, buddy.
Thanks, bro.